Okay, so today we're going to prove the mean value theorem. And so before we prove the mean value theorem, I'm going to draw the graph of the mean value theorem. This is the icon that tells us what the mean value theorem says. We have a continuous function defined on a closed interval from A to B. It's differentiable on the open interval from A to B, and we compute the slope of the secant between B and A. And there's a point between A and B that we call C, at which the slope of the tangent is equal to the slope of the secant. So f is continuous on the closed interval a and b. It's differentiable on the open interval a b. And this implies that there exists a number c between A and B, at which the derivative of F is equal to the slope of the secant. Well, the slope of the secant is going to be F of B minus F of A, all over B minus A. Okay, now we want to prove this, and we're going to prove it using Rolle's theorem. And one of the ways of proving it using Rolle's theorem is just to tilt your head until this line is horizontal, and then we're looking for a horizontal tangent. But what we're going to do is we're going to tilt our head algebraically here. So let's look at this secant line. The secant line has equation y minus f at a is equal to its slope times x minus a. And the slope, remember, is f of b minus f at a over b minus a. And so the secant line is going to be y is equal to f of b minus f of a over b minus a times x minus a plus f of a. And what I'd like to do is I'd like to take this line and I'd like to either add it or subtract it from the given function. So let's define a new function. Let's see, g of x. And I want g of x to be my original function, f of x. And I want that g, it's going to be f of x plus something. I'm going to take a guess and think that it's actually this. And let's see what happens with this function. I might be wrong about this sign, and if I am, I'll fix it later. So we got g prime of x is equal to f prime of x plus f of b minus f of a over b minus a. You see, that's the slope of this added on term. So the derivative of this term, a and b are constants, so the derivative of this term is just the slope. The derivative of f of a, that's also a constant. So the slope here is f prime of x plus the slope of the secant. Now let's look at g of a. G of a is going to be equal to f of a. And you know what? I know that I want to subtract. So I'm going to put a minus sign here. I'm going to put a minus sign here. And f at g of a is going to be f at a minus f of b minus f of a over b minus a times 0 plus f of a. And I left off a pair of parentheses like that, so g of a is equal to 0. G of b is equal to f of b minus f of b minus f of a over b minus a. That's times b minus a, and then plus f of a on the outside. And the b minus a's cancel. What do I got here? I got the f of b's cancel.
And the f of a's cancel.
And the negative. F of a's cancel, so I still get 0. Okay, good. So this function g is a function that's 0 at a, it's 0 at b. Rolle's theorem says that if I've got a function that's 0 at the two endpoints of the interval, then there, as long as the function's differentiable, then there's a point in the interior at which the slope of the tangent is equal to zero. Now, the slope of the tangent is going to be zero, so that's going to be f prime minus blah, blah, blah. And so g prime at c is supposed to be equal to zero. That's going to be f prime at c plus f at b minus f at a over b minus a. And that's it, right? And minus, this is a minus, so that means that that's f prime at c is equal to f of b minus f at a over b minus a. And so the mean value theorem follows from Rolle's theorem. And let's try to understand why Rolle's theorem works. I'm not going to give a rigorous proof here. I'll wave my hands a little bit. So we start out with a function g that's 0 at a and 0 at b. And if the function is constant, then the derivative is 0, because the derivative of a constant is 0. If the function is not constant, then it's either going to start getting positive or negative. And it could do something. I mean, it could do something like that, but let's just go ahead and assume, for the sake of drawing the picture, that the function remains positive. Now, if the function remains positive, then it achieves a maximum value, because a continuous function on a closed interval achieves a maximum value. Wherever that maximum value is, if you compute the slope of the secant, to taking the secant line to the left, you'll find out that the slope of the secant is positive. If you compute the slope of the secant at the maximum value to the right, you find out the slope of the secant is negative. Since the slope of the tangent is equal to the limit of the slope of the secant, one's positive and one's negative, therefore the slope of the tangent should be equal to zero at the optimal point. Now, when I said optimal point, you see that I just can redo the argument if the function becomes negative. So whenever we have an optimum, then we're going to find out that the tangent is horizontal at that point. So that's the argument for Rolle's theorem. Rolle's theorem implies the mean value theorem. The mean value theorem is just Rolle's theorem turned on its side. And it's curious that the mean value theorem followed the Rolle's theorem by about 50 years.